Welcome to a quick introduction using drag drop in boom cards. I'm starting with a brand new deck here, and I always like to start my decks in the template card. It just minimizes changes that I have to make later. I'm going to go ahead and grab a few elements and put them on the page. Let's call this drop zone. We wouldn't put this obviously for our kids. We'd do a much more clever design, but just to quickly kind of show how this works. Let's give it a border, because that's what we'd probably do for our kids. And maybe a color of, there we go. All right, so this is where the kids are gonna drop something. And let's give them something to drag around. Let's give them a couple colorful animals. So it looks like a little penguin. And let's go ahead and clone these guys. So we have several that are the same size. Whoops, and there we go. Select those, let's align their tops. Looks good, and then we better space this guy out a little bit. Okay, now we've got our things that we want the student to be able to drag around. Let's, since this is the template card, we're actually kind of just ready to go. One more thing we can do on the template is we can go ahead and mark these as the draggable items, and you'll see they get little hands, and we can mark this one as the drop zone, and he gets a little flag. This is the clear thing, so if you select something and you're like, whoa, wait, this wasn't supposed to be draggable, you can turn it off, or like, you know, I made the mistake. That's not the draggable thing, that's the drop thing. So that's how these work. They flip these around, and then this just turns it off. All right, so now I've got the items that are gonna be on my page in the template that are marked. And now I should go to each individual card. And it's important, don't wire this up in the template, because it will create some issues later. Actually, let me just show you what I mean by what it's going to do for issues. The way we wire these up, I'm going to pop down to an actual card, wire it, and then I'll show you why it would be somewhat problematic if you do it on the template. I'm going to drag this thing over, and this is how I indicate what should get dropped here. And I guess we should also make this card look a little different. So let's put a mammal there. Okay. I guess we'll go back to the template and ask a question. Question. And let's size this out. Let's go ahead and move this one down a little bit. And then we'll go to our card and say, which is the mammal? Now, we know that this should be the correct answer, so we'll drag it. Now again, if we drag it over here, nothing happens. If we drop it in the middle of the drop zone, nothing happens. We have to line it up with this flag, and then it wires it up and says, okay, this guy is the draggable item that should line up in here. And if we preview that for the students, we can drag our elements around. If we drop them any place that's not in the drop zone, and we really only require about a 55 or 60% of the object to go in there. So as you can see, he's not really in there, but he's close enough. My mouse isn't even over the drop zone. And so as soon as enough of him is in there, we consider it in and we highlight it. And if he drops it, now this is not the right answer. When the student submits it, he gets it marked wrong. You hear the whoops and everything snaps back. He could do something like this, still wrong. When he finally gets the correct answer, then we're okay. So now we're back into the editor. Let's see how we like fix something. So we go to this card, and we think we want giraffe and fish, and we want this one to be the correct answer. So we'll drag him over. And we write the question, like, wait, no, that's actually not the right answer. So how do we fix that? So we select the drop zone, and we look and we say, oh, this is wired up to that guy. And for now, the way the user interface is set up is you just clear everything out, turn the drop zone back on, and then drag the actual correct answer in here. And now you're wired back up. And if we select this, we can see a different ID is listed here. So that's how the drag drop works. And you're pretty much good to go at this point. And as you look at each one of your cards, you see, you can see what the correct answers are supposed to be and how this is going to work. We could stop here. You've kind of really have everything there is to know about using drag drop. But now, if you want to just stick around for a little bit more of the advanced topics, I'll cover a little more information. So I had said don't mark stuff on the template card for answers, and there's a reason why. If I go ahead and I say on the template card that this is the correct answer, what that actually does is it wires up and says that the idea, this middle guy, is supposed to be the correct answer. When I add a new card here, you can see this is already wired up, and then I say, but that's not the one I want. I want it to be this guy. Now I've got two correct answers, and I want to really get rid of this. So I select the drop zone and I say, clear it. But as soon as I turn it drop zone back on, it inherits from the template card that this is the correct answer. So this is really not a good way. We're really stuck. Now, the other cards are still okay because we wired them up before we did the change to the template card. But just not great to wire up the drag drop using your template cards. We'll go back in here, we'll turn off the drop zone thing. We turn it back on, and then in our individual cards, we want to wire up the correct answer. Now, you may have just noticed that we can have more than one correct answer. Drag one penguin up. Now, the reason I said drag one penguin is there's a couple of ways we could have done this. We could have said that all the answers are required, or one of the correct answers is required. And right now, at this point, we just will take one and be happy. Later, I think we might add a flag that says all correct answers must be selected. It seems like the more likely thing that an author is going to want. Okay, so now when a student does this and he says drag one penguin up, it could be any one of the penguins. He submits it and it's correct. Which one's the mammal? This guy. Good. And which one is the fishy? Good. Okay, so I said we could talk about some other advanced features. So I want to go back in to my template card, select all the items, delete them all, start from scratch, and give a really fun example. So here's a multiple choice scrambly thing with pictures, but let's just make it a little bit bigger. And maybe four is the right answer, or maybe we come down here and we say it'd be better with only three, and we can just delete one of these. Now, the other thing I want to do, if you notice, these two here are marked as wrong answers, and this one's marked as a correct answer, but that doesn't make any sense for what I want to do, so I'm just turning those off. So I'm in my template. I've got this neat little randomizing container, and I know it's a randomizing because it says randomize here. And then let's make another drop zone. I always like to use text elements for my quick things. We can get rid of that text. We can put a quick border on here. And maybe even a little background, something subtle. Let's try this again. I want to center that. Okay, so we have everything nicely centered. Looks good. Let's mark this as a drop zone, and let's mark each one of these. Oh, and someone asked about this. So if you select one of the items in here in Command A, you'll select everything inside the container. If you are, if you have the card kind of selected in Command A, you'll get everything in the card at the top level. If you have something in a container in your Command A, you get just the container thing. So inside here, let's mark these as draggable, and then let's go to a card. And oh, actually, remember I said don't do this in the template, but because we're going to do auto randomize and everything, this is maybe the one time where I say, yeah, sure, go ahead and wire this up for the template. So this is all, the first one's always the correct answer, but of course it's going to get randomized. So when you design your card, always make the correct answer here, because that's the way it's wired up. So draft better be the correct answer. And then whatever you put here, that can be something different. We come in here and duck better be the correct answer. And now when we actually preview this, so duck is the correct answer for this card. And in this example, he showed up in the first position, but it was randomized, and I previewed again, and now duck's over here, and of course he is the correct answer. And we have a little bit of a Z order problem. We'll get that fixed up, but for now we're just gonna fix it by doing this. I want to do a Z order, send it to the back. That should fix it. And there we go. Whoops. All right, and then remember, duck's the answer here. I should do one more quick example. So back to the template card, select everything. Let's go ahead and delete everything from here. I'm going to go on to just one card, because as I'm building this, I'm thinking, oh, my cards are a little different. They don't all look the same. So just on this card, I want to have maybe two zones. One here. And, whoops. And one here. And I think I better do something to make them look like they're zones. Okay. And now I want something to be draggable. So let's put a couple of these guys out. Let's try it like this. Okay. We'll say froggy and fishy. Maybe we can say amphibian. Amphibian. First thing we got to do is make these drop zones. All of these need to be draggable, and fishy needs to go here, and amphibian needs to go here, and then the student somehow has some instructions and knows that fish needs to go in here, froggy needs to go here. Submit it. And that's great. Now, if we did this, let's see what happens when the student does it a little bit wrong. That's what a fish is. But he's not sure. He thinks giraffe might be an amphibian because he's got a long neck. So he submits that. He gets it marked wrong, and the correct answer is still up there, so he knows to go ahead and do this. And ta-da! All right, that's it. We're still in beta. Let me know if you want to change any of the behaviors, or if you have any questions, suggestions. Thank you for watching.